everybody, we are finally starting the game. This was the knock round. Had to skip it fast because sadly everybody started without even giving any hint that okay, they're ready. The last guy just entered and okay, they went straight for the knife rounds. Managed to give you just a bit of what happened there. Sorry about that. All the times before now, it took a bit of time to come after the last guy joined, so yeah, I still have to work on that. Together with me tonight is going to be Grumble. Say hello to everybody.
Good evening.
How are you? I hope everything is fine.
Yeah, everything's going well.
Okay, so I promised the people that we'll have a small discussion about the teams. So, what can you tell me about these two teams?
Okay, well, ESC is a more well-known team. They've been around a little longer. And G.Lions, it was a lot more harder to find any information about them. They're a SIVO main team, so really the only comparison I can make is that they're a league below ESC, so based off that, I think ESC should take the game, but I've never seen this team play, I've never seen G9, so I'm kind of excited to see what'll happen.
Okay, just a second, I will do one more, and we'll need to lower a bit the sound of the game, I think, to check it out. Okay, good. Didn't have too much time to settle in for the technical design. I'm sorry about that. Tried to stream the game as fast as possible. It came literally just a few minutes before the game should start. So, yeah, and I didn't put in the streaming mic, let's say. So, if the mic will be a bit bad, sorry about that. We'll try to work it out for the tomorrow, I think. Yeah, I hope it doesn't do sounds that I didn't have time to set up. Okay, I think we should concentrate right now on the game. This is the first round that was taken by ESC Gaming that are now playing on T-side. And
yes,
they lost, sadly, Lions lost the first round. And I, from what I was able to see in the chat, everybody favors Lions.
Alright, well, it looks like Lions is going to force by here, getting pistol armor. And it might actually be productive, considering ESC didn't invest in a single rifle, going all SMGs. Three players running down mid.
They managed to take out two already, and now it's 4 versus 3 players. Now I'm going to make that 1 minus 5.
It looks like they're going to split banana. And now the B-bomb site's wide open.
Yeah, they want to go on B side. They have to be careful because there are two Lions that are coming, and he is in ruins.
Yeah, this situation actually really favors Lions. Looks like their force are going to pay off. Yeah, just as I say that.
Yeah.
Still, 9 HP between both of the ESC players.
And
the bomb will get planted.
Yeah, and now it's a 2v1 situation, plus the bomb is planted. It seems like he wants to go to try the ruins. Let's see how this will work. It seems like Nex will try to go and catch him from behind. The flanking, it's real, gets closer and closer. Oh, will it be? Yeah, he did. Will be an execution. Complete execution there. And they managed to take the second round without too much problems. And to be honest, I'm a bit surprised to see P90s. You don't really see so many P90s in this type of games. Usually you see in pop,
yeah,
but
especially on a T side.
Mm-hmm.
On some maps, you know, the P90 holds value in holding some of like the smaller angles, like on maybe Nuke, for example, but on T side of Inferno, not really expecting to see a P90.
Yeah, exactly. And he just wants to be able to kill a lot of people like he does exactly now, you see, already 2 people down without too much problem.
And right, just one G-Lions player remaining.
Yeah, he's alone against 5 people and the bomb will be planted. Yeah, it's now bomb. And that's the third round for ESC Gaming. And as I was saying, sorry for if the mic is not great. I know I hear, before I was using another one. As I was saying, I didn't have too much time to set up and I hope it's just not too horrible. I'll check the record after.
Oh, it sounds fine.
Okay, perfect. I hope so. Yes, this is the first map, and Lions chose Inferno. The second one would be Mirage, that was selected by ESC Gaming, for people who don't know. And the third map, in case we will have a third third one, of course, will be Overpass.
Alright, so it looks like Lions is going to pick up the first rifle round here. It's down to a 5-on-3. Lions has a 2-man advantage. And
make
now it's down to 5-on-2.
Make that
and place. They have no map control to speak of.
Yeah, but let's not forget about the fact that by now the Lions were on eco, so they had quite a big disadvantage. And somebody asked their question. For those type of questions, guys, I suggest you scroll below my channel and there you'll find a Q&A. Quite a lot of them, so feel free to check them out. Okay, so that makes it 3-1 still for ESC Gaming, but this is the first final round for the Lions. And let's see how they manage now, because they have weapons. This is the second round when they do. And yeah, I'm expecting quite a lot, especially from the hype that we managed to see on the chat. People favoring Lions quite a lot. Seems like there will be some action in the apartment. Two people went down. That, it's almost 3. Q-Pad is running very low, only 20 HP left. And they will rotate to Banana, trying to do something.
Est has control of Banana, but they don't have the bomb.
Yeah, it's dropped. I'm not sure what they're trying to do there. I mean, okay, they got the Repo got the kill there, but
they got the entry frag, but it's traded off. That was just Repo without the bomb and 8 HP.
Yeah, he's just solo without the trying to be a nice kill. I'm not sure why they didn't actually try first to recover that bomb, because what are you going to do when you have low numbers and your opponent has a lot and you just don't have the bomb? So how are you going to win? Just kill them all? It's kind of hard.
It looks like we have a pause coming in here.
Yeah.
And that win, importantly, it's going to put Lions... They're going to be just, map's going to be within 1 point, and it pushes ESC onto eco. If you look at the money situation, all the players in about 2k. Michi's going to pick up a Tech 9 and armor, but everyone else is just on Glocks or P250s.
Yeah, they have to eco, and it seems like indeed after they the Lions managed to get the weapons, so the problem seems like they have some patch losses and stuff like this. Okay, after the... they managed to get the weapons, basically they are starting to win more and more, and now put ESC Gaming on eco. Seems like we are finally back, the game is unpaused, and let's see what will happen this time.
Seems see like what ESC decides to do with their eco round. Looks like they're pushing down alt mid.
Yeah, second
maybe
mid
gonna
and
do a...
Yeah, they go in apartments and maybe also... Yeah, one guy is scouting the mid. Checking out what's happening, trying to get some information. There's still a sniper on the apartment on the balcony, so it's not going to make it easy. The smoke was dropped.
Yes, does take mid control, so that's something.
Yeah, and they also have apartments. Kind of. Now they decide to jump a bit and check around. Now they are playing
Lion.
Passive. They have to be careful because the time is running lower and lower.
Right, Lion's showing a lot of discipline here. They're not. They know that ESC is on an eco, but they're not taking any push, not taking any risks, just using their smoke, staying behind their smokes, playing on site.
Now they use the smoke on B, but I think they tried to wait till they would use everything, but they have to be careful, only 30 seconds left on the clock.
Looks like they're maybe going to try and fake B and hope for the plant on A, but I don't see this working out very well.
Not really. The bomb is in B to A, but they managed to take 2 already down.
They do force some rotates and... Okay, they get the pick. They might get the bomb plant here.
It's very hard because there is a player from Lion here and will try to spam a bit of that box, and the bomb will be planted, but that blast from ESC Gaming going down, last player. They managed to kill 2 people, plant a bomb, which is kind of okay. They managed to get some money from planting that bomb and also killing 2 at the opponents.
Yeah, all in all, a very successful eco.
Yep. Now they can go and buy. And guys, as I was saying, for those kind of questions, please feel free to scroll down to on my channel and you'll find a lot of your questions answered there. Okay, let's see what's going to happen in this round. It seems like a gen they go for
Lions.
A mid. Switching.
Lions is gonna aggressively push down banana, take banana control.
Yeah,
looks like Esk is gonna set up for an A take.
They want to go through that smoke. Let's see if they manage to do something. But we have DMD, and sorry, pew, that will get a kill here from the mid. Just went through the smoke and decided to okay, we'll go and see what happens. Already three players down, fully main, and make it one with 5 HP. And let's see, we're not managing to do too much. It seems like it's harder and harder for us gaming to do something. They had weapons now and couldn't really make too much happen there.
Right, I feel like they tried to take a quicker pace that round and it really didn't work out for them. Tried to force it a little bit too much.
Let's not forget that the map was chosen by Team Lion, so it's their favorite map. Most likely, S Gaming doesn't really want to play it so much, they don't have so much training, so we should consider that as well.
Right, and it's CT sided, so really, as long as S gets 5 or 6 rounds, they still have a shot at the map.
Exactly. Same thing, they want to go for the bit. They have already prepared, but they're still kind of doubting, okay, we go in or not. Let's try to get maybe somebody. And now they go in and three players down and bomb is dropped. Only one remains. Rico has all the pressure on his shoulder. Let's see if he can actually make something happen. Take one down, but it's decent enough. He managed to get one weapon down from G.Lions. Better than nothing, I would say. Let's not forget about the fact that, as you said, this is Infernax indeed a CT-sided map. So, and the fact that they managed actually to take after the first round, they won the pistol round, and they won all the three rounds that actually followed after the first one. So it's kind of decent.
Right, it would definitely make a big difference if Esk wouldn't have gotten anti-eco following the pistol round there.
Yeah. Now they managed to actually start quite okay. Then they took out one of Lion's opponent, one of the Lion's teammates. And let's see if they can find more kills. They are going on mid, trying to see if they can catch somebody. But this time they are playing a bit more defensive. They're playing very passive, trying to get somebody else before they go into that A.
Looks like they're thinking about maybe going B now.
Yeah, the bomb is only now on mid. Coming slow. There, it seems like they want to wait and try to get one more kill. That's what they kind of seem to want. They are using the flashes to try to hold them back. He will throw the bomb and most likely try to have a pick here. Get some info at least, who's where. Nobody around the library, but there's somebody in the city and he's completely flashed, can't really get a kill there. They managed to get another kill, so it's a 3v5 situation, now make it 2v5. They should most likely get this round, they have the bomb planted, only one person from G-Line remaining, and this should really...
Looks like he's gonna run away and save.
Yeah, this should be for sure 5... No, he's not going to save, he wants to go for it. Gets one weapon down from S Gaming. Can he get more? Nah, he will just run and try to survive the round, which will be very
Mike can hunt it down!
He almost managed, but it's kind of like an obvious place where you go, because I think a lot of people try to hide in the apartment, in the kitchen area, in the small kitchen, you know?
Right, well, Lions, after winning all those rounds in a row, is still gonna have more than enough money for a very healthy buy.
Yeah. They can because they managed to win so many rounds in a row, so they're still okay money-wise. Now they are pushing banana, using a smoke, but they go for aggressive defense here. They managed to take one player down, maybe that's the second one, not the risk not happening. The spam through the smoke, will do some damage. And let's see, no, he does not succeed to enter the apartments. There are two players waiting for them, or whoever decides to enter in their territory. We managed to get a nice headshot. The flashbang will not harm him too much. The bomb is sitting on a banana, but they will retreat.
Neeks lurking over on the A site, literally walked right past the guy playing in dark. He's about to come out an alley behind him.
Oh, this is going to be a knife! The knife, it's real! Managed to get that knife kill. They dropped the bomb and I'm not sure what happened there.
S got a... They lost the first two picks, and then they evened it out, and then for some reason decided to run through the smoke and mid and paid for it.
He just stopped. He just stopped in the smoke, didn't move at all, even if he was taking damage. So I'm not sure if that was some technical problem or I'm not sure. Same kind of problem. He just stopped, even if he was taking damage. Who knows? Okay, so that makes it 6-4-2. G.Lions is still leading this. But as you were saying earlier, that this game actually needs to take 5-6-7 rounds would be ideal for them on B side.
And they are going to elect to force up. See if this amounts to anything. Still a decent buy.
We have one person on the apartment, but reds are trying to rush on the arch side, and two already go down, so it's not looking very great for S Gaming again. And they managed to get the person from the pit down. Now another one, seems like they make it 3-4-2. Clear the A side, and kind of looks very good for them. Will it
right,
be 6-5?
G.Lions had the advantage, and then somehow S got all the entry frags onto A.
Ouch. Have you seen the action from the arch? He was a bit lost in the smoke, and he had one person in front of the smoke and one behind it. But Repo managed to get here a kill, and he managed to get the second one as well. Yes, and he takes a round for S Gaming. Six or five, and already starts to look quite okay for S Gaming. And let's not forget about the fact that G.Lions selected this first map.
Okay, and Lions, not sure I agree with this. They are gonna force up. Pretty weak buy.
Mm-hmm.
Very light on the utility, which is super important on Inferno. The smokes, the Molotovs.
You really? I'm not sure what he was doing here. He was just facing the wall, and not sure.
Maybe trying to avoid a flash.
Yeah, but they managed to get the kill through the smoke, but the bomb is planted and they have to do something about it. Either try to save or go for it. But
It looks like they're gonna save. So still there's two M4s.
Yeah, from the look indeed they will try to save. And I'm curious if Peter will No, he doesn't have a weapon. He killed somebody in B, but through the smoke, and it was way too risky to go and try to grab a weapon.
Definitely.
And he does have armor, so it's kind of important, I would say. It's kind of important. You don't really want to just waste it, especially when you don't really have money to work with.
Okay, and after saving that, Lions is going to force up again, and it's actually a little bit of a better buy this time.
Yeah, finally they have at least smoke. Everybody has at least one smoke and...
Right. Yeah. Couple flashbangs, couple Molotovs.
Yeah, you really need them, because you need to try to save as much time as you can when you're on the side. And Peter, he has to be careful. The aggressive play is not going to help them too much. They actually took more rounds when they play defensive than when they try to go for some kills.
Yeah. It looks like that's exactly what they're doing. Lions held on to make control, they're using their smokes.
Repo wants to take a pick here, but decides to back off.
For some reason, Lions is rotating two players over to B at just the wrong time, as S gets the pick onto A.
Yeah, he was just lurking there, and they managed to get quite a decent amount of kills and make that 2 versus 4 plus the bomb that it's now heading to A. They managed to get another kill, and I'm pretty sure he should really think about the idea of saving, because they are not great with money, as I was saying earlier. He wants to get at least one kill, managed to get it. Will it be that second? Nah, he just will try to play it safe, as he should, because it's kind of dangerous. Let's check a bit of money, and yeah, he really doesn't want to lose this M4. But they will hunt him down, they know where he is.
Yeah, and Lions is not going to be on a buy next round. I cannot see them forcing up again.
If they force up going to the Indies, he can't survive the round.
And so now it looks like S should win the half.
Let's see, I'm curious. They go for 5 grand.
Okay, it looks like they're just gonna even up their money a little. Players with extra are gonna get armor, pistol.
Yeah, it's okay, because right now they have an equal amount of money, so... But I'm still not sure, maybe they could have tried, you know, if one person had enough money to buy an AVP, it would have helped them maybe quite a lot. Depending how their AVP feels. Because if he doesn't feel very good on playing that weapon, then better not. And it seems like again they're going A, and they don't really have too much problem. Let's see what will happen in this library. Does not manage to get a kill, if he was low.
We'll see if he decides to try and save this off or go for the retake.
The bomb is planted, so now get the kill.
Stark peaks there, bad time. Just one player left in pit.
Yeah.
He's being closed on from long and balcony. Balcony player takes him out.
Yeah, exactly. And the bomb was not in a good position for him to hold from the pit, because DMN could have at any time go and just defuse it. And he couldn't do anything because he had zero vision.
Yeah, very well played by Lions. Just a couple of pistols and a few Kevlar vests, they managed to take the round.
I really have to say the fact that sometimes I have the feeling that this fight van is OP. I don't know, sometimes it really makes me feel that it's OP, and it's actually close to... today, when I'm talking about impact to an M4 or maybe AK. I feel that they should really a bit nerf that 5-7.
They can't nerf my favorite gun, but you're definitely right.
It's my favorite also. Yes, I also use it a lot, because it's that good, you know? And now they go for mid, let's see what will happen. They managed to take one player down, now from the second, and there's a trade. But just 2-for-1. They throw the Molotovs, but... Not
comes to the smoke! Molsey wins the exchange, now it's 2v1. Still one player hiding in the smoke, gets the kill!
They will get another one, and it's one versus
frags everywhere.
One versus one situation, the bomb is dropped. And, oh, very nice headshot, make that 8-7, but at this point, I would really say S Game is in a better position, because let's not forget, it's a city-sided map, and at this side, S Gaming managed to take 7 rounds, which is, I would say, quite a decent amount of rounds.
Yeah, that's definitely a good half by S Gaming. Lions is really going to want to pick up this pistol round.
Yeah, they need to, otherwise they will have problems. Who takes the... usually, it's not all the time like this, but who managed to take the pistol round has a clear advantage. And most of the time, that team will take at least 2 more rounds. But of course, it depends on the players and how they work together. They go for the mid, they try to rush it, and Repo is only 20 feet, but managed to get the perfect headshot there. Let's see if he can
Demon
get more.
Demon lurking at the bottom of banana. It looks like they're going to go for the exact same line as S did on their pistol round. They're going to split
headshot.
B.
Another perfect headshot, and let's see if he will get the kill there. Yeah, sneaky enough to do the trick. Whoa, he's on fire. Two players
it's just
done.
Mitchie.
Yes.
He does have almost full health. He picks up the defuse kit and a Kevlar vest, so this is definitely doable.
Let's see what he'll manage to do here. He's sure that somebody's on banana, but he already took some damage and he doesn't really check too much of the wounds. Now he should know where the players are. Yeah, perfect headshot.
Oh, great shot.
Can he do the last one as well? Close. And he was running out of time.
Yeah, that was a good try by Mitchy, but Peter in Ruins or Construction there just played it very patiently.
Yeah, the fact that they didn't pick on neither from Banana or Ruins, that was very good because he was already kind of out of time. Even if he, let's say, he could have killed his last opponent, I'm not sure that was a bit close to the limit time. I think he had
well,
like
S-Force is up,
already.
And we'll see if they can do to Lions what Lions did to them to take this round.
Yeah, and they
very quick push down Banana.
Yeah, they go for B, and let's see what will happen. It's a 3v3 situation. The bomb will be... Yes, indeed, it's planted, and we will take that sniper kill without too much problems. Let's see, can he get another one? New boxes and dark.
They know where one player is.
Yep, they managed to spot him. They do manage to hold for now. That one killed that second, and yep, they do take this round. Kind of nice, they play kind of organized, their rushes are actually, they do rush, they don't stop, they no matter what, smoke, molotov, doesn't matter, just go for it, and they execute it so good.
Yeah, that was definitely good execution on the B site. They got in, trading 2 for 2, and now this puts S onto Eco, and it should put Lions up 11-7.
Yeah, they are indeed eco, and they'll have a bit harder time defending because they don't really have anything to work with. No smokes, no molotovs, nothing. Just pistols, then stack on B. Because...
Yeah, I do like the stack because if they play standard, you know, with a couple of P250s against 4 AKs, they don't have a lot of hope, but maybe with this stack, then get lucky.
Yeah, they need to try something. Because all the, they went only once in A, and all the time after they went in B, so they kind of expected it. Let's see what will happen. Yes, the kill! Very nice reactions there.
Lions didn't find a single player on A side after looking around, but they're going to go ahead and rotate back to B. No, back to A.
We'll just remain behind to make sure nobody will come
okay.
on.
Banana. Realizing the A side's wide open, they're going to play the bomb.
Reap on that headshot. Bomb is planted and it's in A. There are two players sitting in B. Let's see what
they're being held there.
Yeah, it's not going to go too well for them and make that 11-7 for G Lions. It seems like for people that bet on G Lions, the dream is getting more and more realistic, you know?
Dreams alive.
Yeah, dreams alive and the. I think, yeah, most of the people actually bet for skin, so I was able to read that somebody also bet Knife, Sad Trap or something like that, so he's getting closer and closer to that
S is going to buy, not a, a decent buy, no head armor, but they're playing against all AKs.
Yeah, they have some smoke they can work with, and not much, but they had something, it's okay. But it's very important how they hold it, because now they G-Lions again, they managed to get the entry frag.
They yeah, so they have mid control and they have banana control. Looking very good for
Lions. Yeah, they have so much info already, so it's so good for them already. They will use the smoke to try to cover if somebody is in that bit. But we have one person on front and one on balcony. See him, but Repo will just execute it.
Right, they know that there's a player dead.
They do, and they go for A. Now here comes the first kill. May. Now, that will be
trades. Comes out in the end favoring Lions. It's 3v2, and looks like S is going to try for the retake.
Yeah, there are only two players left, and they are getting 3 plus the time each, just going in G-Lion's favor. It seems like they both try to go, now finally, nah, they will try to save. This, I think this would be the better play. Yes, they both will save.
Right, I think if they could get an early pick there, they were going to try and go for the retake, but no, they couldn't find any Lions players. Running low on time, they just ran away.
Yeah, it was kind of pointless to try to do that, especially considering their money situation, which does not look very good. But I have to say, I need to mention the fact that Repo, he's having a very nice game and day. He's 18 kills, you know. I wasn't sure how to say 5 kills, you know, kind of the same thing. And on the other side, we have DM10 with 19. Kind of looks good. But Repo, indeed, he has a very, very good day. Gets the kills without much problem.
Yeah.
So this round is going to be kind of passive for G.Lions.
Now, hey.
As Gaming managed to get a kill, first kill on Banana, and a spam will make that second. Use another smoke.
Alright, so it looks like S might finally pick up a CT round. Can maybe start turning this map around, taking some momentum away from Lions.
Yeah, they already have the advantage and the timing in their favor, so that's very important. They have a lot of control. So the fact that they hold kind of, I would say aggressive, that Banana, because most of the time they can hold it, and that's another kill. First kill for G.Lion. That's 2v3. Let's see what will happen, because G.Lion need to do something. Only 35 seconds left on the clock. There's a small
little exchange there in mid between Stark and Mimic. Looks like they're gonna run towards B, which is the right decision. There's only one player here.
And he's using the flash so perfect. He couldn't use it in a better moment. He just stopped the push, and that's the bomb down. Well, only
good
one player left. Managed to get a kill, but he's standing for G.Lions. He's flanked and had absolutely zero ways to get around. 12-8.
Yeah. Very well played by S there. Good hold at the end.
He managed to keep his last flash for the best actual opportunity, because he couldn't ask for more than that. He couldn't ask for a better opportunity to use that last flash.
Yeah. Definitely utilized his utility very well there.
I see that G.Lions decided again to go for a passive play, just try to get a kill or two in A or B somewhere, you know, and after that go for a rush or something. But as we managed to see by now, they had the most success when they just rushed. When they played passive and just waited for S Gaming to peak, it didn't work so well for them. But they still, even so, decide to go to play passive and try to go for some.
Right, last round when they played passive, ESC won the important main battles. And actually, looks like Lion is going to take your advice, and they're just stacking up for an organized B hit, setting up some smokes, just waiting for the smoke to clear.
Yeah, they are prepared, and here comes the rain of smokes and flashes. Let's see what will happen, and they do manage to
push through the smoke. And they take down Stark, just one player left on the site. Quick rotate by Nex.
He will get somebody down, that's one kill for them, so we can make it 4-4. Let's see what will happen. The bomb is very fast planted, gets the trade kill, and make that 2v3. It's looking harder and harder. They managed to equalize it 2v2. And they have better position. G.Lion had a better position, and let's see, do they get another kill here? No.
It's all on DMN.
Come on, he does not manage to hold on.
Good job by Repo.
And Repo again shows what a great day he has.
21 frags. Yeah. Clutches there for his team, keeping them in the game.
Very nice play by Repo. I really have to say that he's really showing off, you know, today. I'm going to win at least this match for my team. I'm going to play so good that everybody will be amazed, even the caster. Okay, so this time seems like again a passive play. Last time, I don't know, they keep repeating the same thing. Even last round, they play passive again. They indeed managed to get some kills, and only Reaper remained alive, but It doesn't work for them. I'm not sure why they insist to play like this.
Maybe they're just trying to use up a little bit of S utility. Poke around the map a little, then group up for a hit.
Let's see if this plan will work, because now they go for A. They see the person in the pit, but I'm not sure if they manage to see the balcony one. Gets a few picks here, but not the kill. He has to be careful with Repo. It's only 11 HP.
Yeah, pulling back, and looks like they're gonna go for a B hit.
Again, they want to rotate, and the spam through the smoke, it's not going to do the job. He still remains with 22 HP. Alright, that's the bomb down. They do manage to clear, still they manage to clear the B side. And here comes the plan. Now they have to just play defensive and let the time go, because it's in their favor. That's one more kill, so that makes it 2 versus 4.
Yeah, that should seal the round. S is gonna run away and save.
Yeah, they should for sure try to save, because the money-wise, it's horrible.
Yeah, all these rounds have been so close, and now S is gonna be on an eco and potentially looking at 14-9.
Yes, G.Lions will take this round as well. After they didn't have so much success, gets killed there. Does not manage to get another one, but looks kind of good. Okay, HP people. Yeah, he was indeed 11 HP. I was curious actually if he'll answer with a true or a truth or not, because lots of people love to troll and say, okay, I had more or less, you know, or just 101. Which is, of course, impossible. And they go again for the passive play. Try to get some info, manage maybe also some pick.
Yeah, S is opts to force up. So they do have armor and pistols. They could definitely make something happen.
G.Lions pick Inferno map, and this is the first map. Oh, already S Gaming remaining in 3 players. Let's see how they will manage, because they have 2 on B and only 1 on A. Oh, very nice shot through the smoke. He even uses an emoticon to express his feelings related to it. And I was actually expecting it as a hex.
Okay, walking right past Minoshi in the smoke, okay. 3 players just walked past him. He's gonna peek! Oh, and doesn't get a single frag. Very unfortunate. Now it's just Repo. He's gonna be forced to save.
He
does have an AK, a lot of utility, defuse kit, armor.
That's not the way you are going to save. Being so close to your opponents when they are 4 alive and they will just want to jump on you and get that weapon. He does manage to get 1 kill, but now he has to be a bit more careful, because indeed there are 2 players from G.Lion coming that are not perfect kills, 3
wow.
kills! Oh
three
my
kills.
God!
Okay.
Repo is
yeah, you
on
said it,
fire.
He's feeling confident this game.
Repo is on fire, seriously. Only 1 person left alive, and let's see, will he manage to get 2 kills? He's going live, not looking there. Oh my god, he
oh.
does manage to get the 4th kill! He's playing so good. They're really, really brilliant play from Repo. 14-9, he does not manage to get around, but kills everybody from G.Lions team.
Right, so if S wins this round, it should put Lions onto a save and maybe give them a window back into the game. But we'll see another very weak buy here coming out of S.
Let's not forget about the fact that the next map is S Gaming map, so yeah, they will feel a bit more confident there. Even so, it's 14-9, they still have a chance, but they should not lose this round if they want to have more options. They will be in deep eco next round, so it's going to be very hard. They really need to do a lot in this one. Oop! Nimex almost had a friendly fire there. That the kill, first kill, second kill actually of the round, and doesn't look so good for G.Lions, but S Gaming looks better and better. That's the first kill for them. Only.
But it gets traded right back out, and another trade. 3v2 now. Oh, Mitchie, he had to get that frag there. That was an important frag.
Very important. But let's not forget about the fact that G.Lions has two players left alive, but they are low HP, and S Gaming has two also, but with full HP. So, but yeah, Stark managed to get the kill. One more player remaining for G.Lions.
Wins the first trade, two health.
1v1 situation, and managed to get the round. G.Lions.
Insane clutch there by Mimic, and probably wrapping up the first map for his team.
This looks more and more that G.Lions will take the first map. But I'm very hyped to see what will happen on Mirage, which will be the second map. And I will say again, S Gaming chose it, so it's going to be on more on the side. Deagle, perfect aim. Just one shot, one kill, and make that headshot. Again, they play passive, they try to get more kills before they go somewhere. Because the smokes right now, they are kind of covering the entrances and makes it very difficult.
Yeah, they're all on pistols. They started the round with a decent amount of utility.
The headshot, Deagle power.
Yeah, nice one deke by Stark.
What can you say, you know, Deagle, when you know how to play with that weapon, that pistol is just brilliant. Can really give us some show. First kill for G.Lions in this round. So that makes it 3v4. 40 seconds left on the clock. The bomb will be picked now. Peter, it's only 10 HP and goes in the apartments. He will manage to get that kill, but now they do know where he is. But the bomb is going on banana. Only one player in B.
Just the notion, 20 seconds.
Let's see. What he can do is he's 1v3. It's very hard, looking very hard.
10 seconds.
Not enough time, and that Fizeman will get the target without too much problem. They still want to, they're still in it, they want to try to actually get the first map, but G.Lions are just one round away from winning the first map. Let's see, will they play again passive or try to rush something? Because they can actually afford right now to play around and, yeah.
It's a full eco.
Sometimes
I imagine. It's like, yeah, they're just gonna poke around the map a little, try and maybe get a kill. Get S to use up as much of their grenades as they can.
Oh, he was completely aiming with the two players there. He can't really get any kill at all there. So only one person left alive. Will he? Yes, he does.
Wow, nice burst shot with the Glock.
Yep, he's very low HP, only 18, and not going to get another kill, but we're still nice attempt. 15 to 11.
Lions can go for a buy here, but it won't be extremely strong. Okay, yeah, they're gonna buy up.
They do
losing
buy up.
Some of the utility.
Next, it's going to handle on AVP. Let's see what he can do with it. First kill, yes, indeed. First kill on that mid. Uses the flash to be able to pick again. It's only one HP left. He's very, very low, needs to be careful. Throws the grenade and won't do too much damage. There are still two players, with one with 15 and the second one, Peter, with 6. They have to be careful. This is still the first map, so nobody won yet.
Right after this is Mirage.
Yep. Repo, repo, get the kill, get the second kill, bomb is dropped. He's, and I'll say, he just has brilliant day. 28 frags, just look at him. And he knows that there's somebody in the apartment, smoked it up, tried to buy as much time as he can. Only 30 seconds left on the clock.
Right. Lions has to decide. Okay, yeah, now Mosey's probably just going to try and save his AK.
He has
now,
to.
Overtime's a very real possibility.
Yeah, we're getting closer and closer, actually, to those overtimes. If he loses the AK, it will be very hard for them, because they will not have not even one weapon. You can look at the money, and they are not looking great.
Right, without a plant.
Yeah. One second, and that's the round going in favor of S Gaming. 15 to 12. And now they're eco, only one AK and some Tech 9s. Three Tech 9s. Actually, make that four.
Yeah, what? You know what, they have still two more rounds to play with after this one, and they're gonna force up here. I really don't agree with it, but Tech 9.
They're playing a bit with fire, and it seems like it's going to be a rush on Banana, but Reaper.
Straight through the Molotov.
Reaper goes for it, gets three kills. Let's see, 4-1, and Reaper can shows off.
He gets the 4K.
That's and... semi.
Yeah, so now, once again, Lions are not going to be able to get a full buy. They're going to opt to get armor, and P250s, and Tech 9s. And then, should be a round for S Gaming, then we'll be on match point. Final round will be a buy, full buy round.
They really need to try to plant that bomb, otherwise it's going to be difficult money-wise. And here's the first kill for S Gaming. They want to go right. For it, but... they didn't have the smoke landed yet, and he was still dancing on it. They do manage to get a trade kill there, but it's looking not so great for G.Lions. Oh,
yeah, Est is playing a little bit aggressively, and it's costing them. Just trying to force the banana control.
Yeah, they need to try to be very careful, because if they lose one single round, then they lost the first map. So they have to be very careful.
Right, no, so close to overtime.
Safe. Yes. I'm pretty
It'd be
sure
a shame
they,
if they lost to an eco.
Minik has an M4, but he's low HP, 12 HP only. So from HP point of view, S Gaming has the advantage, and time, of course.
Yeah, I didn't see how, but somehow Mimic worked his way all the way around, looks like through Archway into B, and he's going to be flanking Stark. Now that gives them the B bombsite. And it's just up to Reaper, once again, to retake 2v1.
Reaper, will you manage to save your team again? Will you manage to do that? Like the all the eyes on Reaper. He's going in, does not want to sit around and chat. Let's see, can he get... Yes, that's the first kill.
Gets the frag.
One person left alive. He's very
not expecting the other player to be in dark. He's gonna stick it, he's gonna...
Oh, G.Lion managed to get this first map. Very nice attempt, but he didn't check. He could have checked a bit the dark, because dark and new box are places where a lot of people like to sit. But very nice game. I really am pleased with the first game we had today. We'll go in a bit in the second one, which will be in a few minutes. So till then, we'll have a bit of music and we deserve a small pause. Thank you all for being here, and we'll come back in a few minutes. Don't go anywhere.